Welcome to Ford Center at the Star in Frisco, Texas, a destination for football fans. And for this week, Conference USA basketball fans alike, UTSA and Western Kentucky in the house. Next. Session begins in earnest. Conference USA men's basketball takes center stage on this quarterfinal Thursday. UTSA, one of the hottest teams in Conference USA, taking on Western Kentucky, the cream of the crop this year in conference play. Now we show you the men's bracket, and the semifinal round is about to begin to be filled in. Western Kentucky and UTSA, the opening salvo of four quarterfinal games on this Thursday night. Great to be with you once again. Chris Foster's the coach, John Giannini. What do you make of this matchup? Western Kentucky, the established power in conference, UTSA, red hot right now.
Well, let's talk styles first. Both teams want to run, and neither are going to slow down. It's who runs best, who wins the battle of transition. Then matchups. The best big man in the league, Bassey. The best scoring guard in the league, in Jackson. A little David versus Goliath theme going on here today.
Javon Jackson might be the best scorer in college basketball that most fans have never heard of, Doc.
He is an incredible shot maker from deep. Look at that. And that's just the start. How about a left-handed runner? Don't see that often. Right-handed runner can do that, obviously, with the strong hand. Step back, create space. That's a pro shot. Then this shot, this is an out of this world, out of the gym shot. And listen, don't be surprised. That's normal for Jackson.
Looks like he's been studying his Kobe Bryant, Dwayne Wade film. When you talk about hot teams, maybe you think they've won four in a row, five of six. These guys have won 10 of 12. They are scorching hot right now, trying to pull off the upset against Western Kentucky. But Western Kentucky has got the player of the year and the defensive player of the year in conference, Charles Bassey.
If you get beat, he'll come and clean it up. And his own man, listen, his own man has to worry about getting his shot blocked too. Pick and rolls. He's outstanding. That's going to be a theme in this game. Stop Bassey's dunks on the pick and rolls. Then how are you going to guard him down low? Even if he misses the first, remember, this guy is a double-digit rebound guy. Over the rim, runs the floor like a deer at almost 7 foot. Then that's the three. That's the one the NBA is going to love about this guy.
The junior is really the Giannis Antetokounmpo of Conference USA. He swept player of the year and defensive player of the year this year. And he's first in the conference in rebounds, shooting percentage, and blocks. A two-way threat indeed. So it's Western Kentucky versus UTSA from the north side of the Metroplex. Tip-off in the quarterfinals coming up next. Got to admit, even in a basketball context, that star is pretty cool. The home of Conference USA basketball this week, and our first quarterfinal matchup of the night, UTSA versus Western Kentucky. Our starting lineups for UTSA: Cedric Alley Jr., Javon Jackson, Jordan Ivy, Curry, Keaton Wallace, and Jacob Germany. For Western Kentucky, Josh Anderson, Tavion Hollingsworth, Davion McKnight, Carson Williams, and Charles Bassey. This matchup, Coach, in particular, as we look at our players to watch, Keaton Wallace and Tavion Hollingsworth, on a lot of other teams, these are the guys, but they're quote-unquote second fiddle in their respective teams.
Well, they're both good scorers. The crazy thing is their consistency. They've done it their whole career. Keaton Wallace, over 2,000 career points. It's ridiculous. Hollingsworth, over 1,800. These guys are both among the top scorers in college basketball for their careers. And yet on their own teams, they're kind of Robin to other Batmen.
Steve Henson was an outstanding college and professional player in his own right. Fifth season at UTSA. Point guard at Kansas State, member of the Kansas State Athletics Hall of Fame, a seven-year NBA career. And Rick Stansbury in his fifth season in Bowling Green. Of course, an SEC Coach of the Year in his tenure at Mississippi State. And he's got a really good program in Conference USA as well. The tip-off is won by Jacob Germany and UTSA, but we had a false start. We've been sprinkling in a lot of football references as we're here at the Star, practice facility of the Dallas Cowboys, and a high school football venue as well in this football-crazy state, but pretty good basketball as well.
Check out Williams, the power forward for Western Kentucky. He might have football in his future. Excellent basketball player, but boy, he looks like he could be practicing in this facility with the helmet on.
Tavion Hollingsworth, whose wife gave birth to a daughter earlier this week, his second child, and eventually the ball gets into the hands of Carson Williams, who opens the scoring for Western.
Three-point shooting for Western Kentucky is huge because you know they have the inside game. If they start making threes, it's a long night for anyone they're playing.
Here's Keaton Wallace, a 2,000-point scorer, one of two on the UTSA roster, both four-year program guys as well. Wallace off the front iron. Ivy Curry saves it, tries to find Jordan Germany, but it is tipped out of bounds. This is the dynamic duo for the Roadrunners, by the way. Javon Jackson and Keaton Wallace, a combined nearly 4,600 points, third most in the same recruiting class in NCAA history. Astounding numbers.
Truly is. Like the kind of numbers you just might not see again in your lifetime, even.
Cedric Alley Jr. in and out, and there's the first rebound of the game for Charles Bassey. Off the hand of Hollingsworth and out of bounds, it comes back to UTSA.
We'll go back to Williams, the football example, but also that made three. So last year, Bassey was hurt. Bassey came back better than ever. But last year, Williams was an all-conference player playing in the post. Now with Bassey in the post, he's had to expand his game. A little less productive, but still a tough, experienced guy.
3-0 Western Kentucky early as UTSA looks for its first points of the quarterfinal. First game of the tournament for Western Kentucky. UTSA is tuned up after a win last night, and that's Jordan Germany to make it 3-2 Western Kentucky.
How about Germany at 6'11 with the mid-range game, and anything you could do to get Bassey to come away from the basket, whether it's having to guard a guy who can make a jump shot or a pick and roll, you want to get Bassey away from the basket.
Off the screen, Tavion Hollingsworth in and out. Bassey with the offensive rebound, and he is fouled on the end line. Actually, the ball was batted out of bounds, correction, so it is Western Kentucky ball. And
something a lot of people have done is run a lot of pick and rolls against Bassey just so he can't stay in the lane, so
yeah.
He has to help out in guards. You have to, can't let him protect the rim because you might not ever score in the paint if you don't get him out of there.
And there is a foul that time, but an offensive foul called on Bassey. Even though he hit the deck, it's UTSA ball.
This is the tough part of officiating. First, Bassey, see if Bassey stick his arms out? That's where the foul was. The second foul is Germany threw him down, but the officials are taught to call the first foul, and Bassey can't stick his arms out as much as he did.
Jordan Ivy Curry with the step back, and that goes for three.
That was a transition defensive problem because Bassey should not have been guarding a guard on that play.
He's the defensive player of the year, but you still don't want that matchup for him.
Right.
He can shoot that shot, however, from the top of the key. It was a good look, and Javon Jackson skies for the rebound. To his Robin Keaton Wallace, the dump off to Germany, and there he is denied by the defensive player of the year.
That's why you don't want Bassey at the rim, because he'll just toss things.
Three-point try in and out for Western Kentucky. Germany eventually corrals the rebound.
That was a 50-50 rebound Germany won against Bassey, though. Germany an ascending sophomore big man.
Ivy Curry tied up at the free throw line, able to roll it out to Germany with 15 on the shot clock. Cedric Alley Jr. looking for a handoff and eventually finds Ivy Curry, who launches with six to shoot, and the rebound down to Williams. Bassey wanted it inside, and there was a whistle.
So rim protection is everything. That's a NBA level block above the rim. I mean, it's really difficult to score on Bassey down there, and that's so critical because the most efficient shot in basketball are shots in the paint. If you eliminate defensively shots in the paint, you're going to win a lot of games. Bassey does that single-handedly.
from the elbow. Elbow, Hollingsworth rims out. You saw that in the women's portion of the bracket earlier today. 6'9 center Mulkey for Rice really can take away the post presence. And Cedric Alley Jr. coughs it up, and it's taken away by Western after a foul on Alley Jr.
That's amazing. We're seeing a top three shot blocker in back-to-back game, or back-to-back sessions. One with the women's program, with Mulkey at Rice, and then, of course, Bassey here. But it has a huge impact on the game. And no secret that both those teams won the regular season championships with elite rim protection.
Yes.
Huge.
Charles Bassey, defensive player of the year on the men's side. Nancy Mulkey on the women's side. And there's Josh Anderson, who picks up his first deuce of the game.
Anderson and Hollingsworth are masters of the mid-range. You talk analytics, the mid-range is not as efficient, but if you make it, I heard one coach say 2 points is better than none. I want those guys to take those shots.
Empty possession for UTSA, and the rebound to Davion McKnight, who sprints down the other way. Anderson thought about pulling the trigger. Around the Williams screen, Hollingsworth back to Williams, who hit a three already, and now is 1-for-2 from deep.
Both these teams are running, but the defenses are recovering.
Wallace with a tough look, and Bassey got caught up in the net there. UTSA able to keep the ball, and they still have it after a couple of offensive rebounds by Eric Parrish. Wallace on the crossover step back. That's why he's got 2,000 points.
Yeah, those step backs are so hard to guard. The defense cuts you off. Now you just step back, and all of a sudden you have space. But you got to learn to shoot with that kind of balance, actually moving away from the basket. It's a highly skilled shot.
McKnight whips a pass into the corner. Off the mark, Anderson. McKnight grab that rebound from the chandelier. Entry feed, Williams. He's knocked down. And we head to timeout.
Here's the big block. Get it out of here. That's my house. And then the step back pro move. Give me a little space. Knock it down. Old school mid-range by Wallace. 7-5, Texas San Antonio.
Quarterfinal round underway from the Star in Frisco, Texas. It is 7-5, the 4-seed UTSA with an early lead over Western Kentucky. And remember, Stadium is the only 24/7 network available on both television and digital devices without a cable subscription. Live and classic games, daily studio shows, original programming. Check your local television listings or go to watchstadium.com. Stadium, welcome to the game and welcome to our game. Chris Fosters and John Giannini with you. For UTSA, we're expecting big things from Javon Jackson in this game, and it was really interesting talking to you, Doc, about what you saw him doing in warm-ups before the game.
Practicing the toughest shots he could. He had an assistant coach put a forearm on him and kind of push him towards the sideline, then catch the ball with the assistant coach in his face, and he was knocking him down shot after shot. He's actually like simulating a game winner type situation, and I've never seen that before, short of like a Steph Curry type warm-up.
McKnight with a tough look underneath, and Jackson came up with the basketball. He's taken just one shot so far today. Parrish with an open lane, and boy, did the Red Sea close quick, thanks to Charles Bassey. Hollingsworth, a two-point shot. He's cold tonight. Bassey over the smaller Wallace could not get the putback.
In the opening, I mentioned both these teams want to run, but there, the transition defense is good. So who's going to win the transition battle? Who's going to get a couple easy ones and have the defense break down on the other end? But both these teams want to go.
Over 6 minutes in, and a fairly low-scoring start. UTSA with a 10-point win over Charlotte yesterday in its opening round. Western Kentucky, the double bye by virtue of its high seed in Conference USA. Bassey dribbles the ball off his leg, but a bailout foul is called.
Wow. watch Bassey run. This guy has unique athleticism, not only the jumping and the strength, but the running. Now look at him go out the other way. I mean, guy has a little bit of Usain Bolt in him at 6'11".
And truly a physical specimen, 6'11", 235 pounds from Lagos, Nigeria. This is his third season with Western Kentucky. He's a junior and has been on the NBA radar for a long time now, as you can imagine. Was considered largely to be a one-and-done prospect as a freshman at Western Kentucky. Came back for his sophomore year, and then in early December of 2019, he broke his leg and was out for the remainder of the season, essentially forced his hand to come back for his junior year, and he has taken over Conference USA this year. Jordan Rawls misses the layup. There's Carson Williams inside, and he is hacked.
So you notice Bassey is out now. Williams individually is better at the center position. When he can just root himself in that paint and use the wide shoulders and the strength to carve out space, it took him all but one play to get an offensive rebound and get to the line at the center position. But the team is better with them playing together.
Williams drains the free throw. He's just a 59% free throw shooter.
So not only because we're in the Cowboys facility, I am a huge football fan. And I asked Coach Stansberry, you know, you see Mo Alley Cox, a VCU guy, basketball player now, a tight end for the Colts. And I said, what about Williams in football? And I'm sure he'd rather play basketball. But he said, I have no idea, but I can tell you two things. He is physically strong enough and he's mentally tough enough. I really think it would come down to like a 40 time, and can he run the way an NFL team would? But the strength and the mentality, boy, he is a tough guy.
Lots of really good football players who had great basketball careers as well. You think of a guy like Tony Gonzalez, who entertained trying out for the NBA when he was holding out on a contract dispute with the Kansas City Chiefs. Jackson nearly had it peeled away by Josh Anderson there, and a travel is called, resulting in a UTSA turnover.
The shot he made, though, the fadeaway, is one of those impossible shots that he's used to. But so this doesn't show up in the stat sheet. Anderson, number four for Western Kentucky, Conference USA, all defensive team. He's doing some lockdown things. Whoever is on him is having a hard time.
Carson Williams, take cover.
Remember, he's at the center position. So now, a 6'11 guy, he could drive by him. He can't drive by another 6'6", 6'7 guy, power forward. But you put a center on him, and he's physical enough to post and quick enough to go by.
Stepping into Charles Bassey's role, bringing the thunder. And Wallace with the answer. He wanted a foul, but he'll take 3 points.
That was a tough shot against Anderson. There's going to be a lot of great one-on-one battles between Anderson, Hollingsworth, and Jackson and Wallace. Now watch Luke Frampton in 14, elite three-point shooter. Can't let him shoot. Make him dribble. The other Western Kentucky players right here. Cut Rawls off. Cut off Williams. It's okay. Let him shoot that three occasionally, but then, geez, don't let him walk in for the rebound.
Well, that's why you follow your shot, but Williams denied again. Jordan Germany turned away by Josh Anderson, who climbed the ladder. Wallace unable to silence the crowd. That one swirls out, and here comes Western Kentucky.
Two all-defensive team players between Bassey and Anderson.
Yeah, we talk about Bassey, and we saw the dunk by Carson Williams, but Josh Anderson is considered a walking highlight reel for Western Kentucky as well. How about Jordan Rawls, the sophomore, for three?
And Rawls is the X factor. Doesn't shoot a super high percentage, but he's a scorer and a little bit of a volume scorer, but Coach Stansberry gives him freedom because he knows he needs those points off the bench.
Parrish blocked, but there was a foul beforehand, and it looks like they're going to get Luke Frampton.
Oh, Williams driving hard, the big fella. That's like the defensive end, tight end, going to the rim. Wow, elevation. Way to go, Williams.
Yeah. So there's been a lot of great basketball already at the Conference USA Tournament, Doc, but I think we have a front-runner candidate for player of the tournament so far on this jam by Carson Williams.
Well, look at how far he takes off from. He takes off from here, and then you look at the vertical. That is some elite athleticism. He is too quick for a center to guard. He can muscle with those guys physically, but he is a tough matchup at the center position when Bassey is out. But I go back again. Williams and Bassey together is still the best thing for the team. But how great is it when you take your first team all-conference center out and you come back with a former third team all-conference center as the backup? Not bad. You can win a championship that way. Didn't Western Kentucky just do that in the regular season?
I think they did. And it's a good problem to have if you're Rick Stansbury, the fifth-year head coach at Western, who just celebrated his 100th win en route to Conference USA regular season championship. Program's first since a 2009 Sun Belt title. Meanwhile, we have Eric Parrish at the free throw line, and he hits the first.
Frampton in the game is really important because you can't help off him. He's that good of a three-point shooter. Been well over 40% his whole career. At Davidson, he and Steph Curry are the only two players, and that's a program that has great shooters every year, to make 100 threes in a season. So that's going to open things up for Bassey,
who is still scoreless, we know. And that pass is picked off by Adrian Rodriguez, who drew the unenviable assignment of guarding Bassey in the post and aced the test.
Rodriguez plays sparingly, but he's kind of like Williams. He's one of those tough guys they put in to make plays like he just did.
He was not on the same page with Javon Jackson there. Rodriguez played just 1 minute in the win against Charlotte yesterday. But no matter, hey, get in there and guard Charles Bassey. You got it.
But you know what? He has that physicality and mentality where he can't wait to guard a guy like Bassey. I mean, that's why he's on the team, for toughness. As we just saw, he's not in there for ball handling or shooting. He's in there for toughness.
Frampton jarred the ball loose and gets rewarded with, we'll call it a slam dunk.
His teammates will get on him about that in future years.
Just as long as he makes it.
Yeah, right now they just want to win the game, but they're going to tease him about that in years to come. Some reunion, some homecoming game down the road. They'll say, remember when you tried to dunk?
And he can just say, hey, at least it counted. No one said it had to be pretty.
Then I'll ask him, how many threes did you make? Did you make as many as Steph Curry? I did.
That's right. Adrian Rodriguez blocked by Bassey, who's been a defensive force. Rodriguez denied again, and a whistle underneath. Player was out of bounds, so it stays on this end.
First effort, second effort, third effort. Oh my gosh. So one of the things Coach Stansbury said that Bassey learned in his year off coming back from injury is the importance of multiple efforts and playing hard every possession.
I'll tell you what, Javon Jackson 0 for 2 today. That was an air ball. And that was a missed three-point try from Kevin Osawe.
I think sometimes Jackson rarely, usually his skill is up to it, but I think he almost has too much confidence that he can make any shot.
Sure. Rodriguez with the lay-in.
Rodriguez is one of those guys that when you put him in, good things tend to happen.
So the second unit on the floor right now for Western Kentucky saved that man, Charles Bassey. And that one rolls around the world and drops through for his first bucket of the tournament.
Yeah, that shot and the shot blocking, if he just keeps shooting, take hundreds and hundreds of game speed shots a day and becomes consistent with his jump shot, he'll play a very long time, health provided in the NBA.
Off to Jordan Ivey, Curry miss. Here come the toppers. Luke Frampton from the wing. Off the heel, Bassey has the long rebound. Jordan Rawls, 4-3.
Western Kentucky's really hard to beat when they get scoring off the bench, and Rawls is the top guy scoring off the bench.
And this is a very good Western Kentucky defense as well. In Conference USA play, they have held opponents to just 32% from beyond the arc, and they're out-rebounding teams by over 7 per game in conference play. But Ivy Curry rounds the corner, makes the extra pass. Maybe that was ill-advised as Rodriguez cannot finish over Bassey.
They might not give it to him, but Bassey got a fingernail on that. That should be a block.
Frampton with the layup. And a timeout, UTSA. Luke Frampton with a couple of buckets off the bench for Western Kentucky as the Toppers up eight. We're just getting started with quarterfinal coverage from Frisco. All part of Conference USA Championship Week. Coming up next, 9:30 Eastern, Louisiana Tech tips off against FAU. You can catch all of the action from the quarterfinals right here on Stadium, the only free 24/7 network available on both TV and digital devices without a cable subscription. All right, a Rick Stansberry timeline for you. From his playing days at Campbellsville University, go Tigers. That mustache, I think, has been outlawed since. Assistant coach and then a very successful head coach at Mississippi State, 2004 SEC Coach of the Year. An assistant coach briefly at College Station for Texas A&M. And since 2016, the head coach of the Western Kentucky Hilltoppers.
So in the SEC, in Coach Stansberry's last 10 years, only Kentucky and Florida won more games. Mississippi State does not have a huge basketball tradition. That's a tough job. Now he's at a school, Western Kentucky, with maybe the best basketball history in his conference. Imagine what he's going to do and look at what he has done now that he's in an advantageous situation as opposed to a really challenging one that he still succeeded with in the SEC.
8-point lead for Western Kentucky. Entry feed Bassey over Germany with Allie draped over him. And the rebound down to UTSA. Javon Jackson still scoreless, Doc. Hard to believe.
The Western Kentucky defense is that good.
Jordan Germany with an offensive rebound, but just couldn't do anything with it. Credit Great. Western Kentucky for that also.
Great rebound, Germany, but here's a simple guideline. If you're not comfortable, don't shoot the ball. Hey, you got the rebound. You got three people all over you. You got Bassey in your face. Kick it out. You know, I never minded anyone taking any shot as long as they were comfortable. I mean, when you're not comfortable, you know, you're clearly not going to make a lot of those shots. And sometimes when a guy gets an offensive rebound, his adrenaline is pumping. And but if you're surrounded, throw it. It's actually a great time to shoot a three because everyone's going for the rebound and people are open on the arc.
A brick from Javon Jackson.
Tell you what, this is the slowest start I've seen Javon Jackson get off to that I can remember.
Could very well be a career slow start for him as Western Kentucky.
But if you look at it, he's not missing open ones. Usually he makes really tough shots. That's what we talked about. He's a tough shot maker, but he hasn't made them here today, but nothing's been easy. And it's been multiple defenders on him. It's been McKnight. It's been Rawls. It's been Anderson. It's been Hollingsworth. A lot of good individual point defenders on this team.
Whistle and a foul as UTSA is trying to rediscover its offense. They've missed 11 of 12. Seven nothing scoring run. Really, when you miss 11 out of 12, you're lucky that the other team has only scored 7 points in that span.
Gonna have a hard time getting this in.
At 6'11", Germany is there.
2-3 zone right now. Nope, back to man.
Wallace, step back from the elbow. He's had it going tonight.
Coach Henson, just that play where the ball went out of bounds, there was that foul. That was an isolation for Wallace. It looks like they're going to start to feed Wallace the ball a little bit more. And what are they saying now? What's that? Let him eat? I think they're going to let Wallace eat a little bit.
That's right. Davion McKnight buys a bucket in the foul.
I'm going to say McKnight is impersonating a freshman. There's no way he's a freshman. I know he's on the all-freshman team, but freshmen aren't supposed to be that strong. Come on, man. And he's been like that all year, backing in a senior. I tell you, McKnight has the right physicality and the right mentality in terms of confidence and maturity. obviously, to have this great freshman year that he's having, but he's going to have a great overall career.
One of two Kentucky Mr. Basketball players on the Western Kentucky roster. Wallace in deep trouble, and a foul is called on Josh Anderson of Western Kentucky.
Chris, first mistake you've ever made.
Because it wasn't, who was the, so the foul was on Wallace. Wow, okay. So it's a foul on UTSA.
No, not the foul. Mr. Kentucky, Hollingsworth, Williams, and McKnight. They got three, Chris.
When did McKnight win it?
Last year. We can debate it.
I'm sorry, I'm a little tied up here at who the foul was called on there. But any, so, no foul. But who, there are there not two Mr. Basketball players on Western Kentucky?
I read three. I believe McKnight was two.
Yeah, that's what I said. I said McKnight.
Oh, and but. Williams and Hollingsworth.
Okay. So, a timeout was called.
Speaking of that, they have a recruit coming in, Zion Harmon, who's a top 20 national recruit, 5'11 point guard, who's also from Kentucky. Might have a fourth Mr. Kentucky with this program next year.
Off the Parrish miss. And there's Javon Jackson making his introduction to this game.
And if he can miss a few in a row, we know he can make a bunch in a row. He could fill it up quick. Well, that was good defense on Parrish, by Parrish, cutting off that Anderson drive.
Carson Williams, right place, right time.
Bassey out, he's back at the center position. It's amazing. But I don't think you want Bassey out too long, though.
Wallace, 10 points.
He's heating up.
Bit of a homecoming game for the senior. Went to high school at Richardson High in Dallas. Hollingsworth, difficult shot, he wanted a foul. And a transition opportunity for Jordan Ivy Curry. Anderson swats that out of the sky. And here comes Tavion Hollingsworth. A bump and a whistle, blocking foul.
The more I watch Anderson, the more impressed I am with him defensively. Parrish first. I mean, this is the LeBron, catch the ball, swat it out of bounds from behind. Look at that, flying down the court, blocked it with his elbow. So Bassey leads the country in dunks, but is the best dunker Bassey because he gets the most, or Anderson because they're the most spectacular? And as a combination, it's the pair have the most dunks as a pair in college basketball.
Taken away. Keaton Wallace.
It's like they caught him pushing off, which again is a sign of good defense. Cut someone off, and sometimes that offense just sticks that forearm out and they think they'll get away with it, but officials are looking for that this year, and it's a good call. Keaton
Wallace. It's the first on Wallace. Hollingsworth with a floater.
And just an individual acrobatic play against good defense. Ivy Curry cut him off, but that floater in mid-range, that's a veteran skilled guy right there in Hollingsworth.
Ivy Curry off the heel. Charles Bassey checking into the scorers table right now. Frampton, he knew that was good.
These teams are running, they're playing free, especially Western Kentucky.
Jackson with another air ball. He is 1 for 5 tonight. Hollingsworth draws the foul.
The Hilltoppers are off and running. They're running downhill.
Running all the way down from Bowling Green.
And they're running back on defense, catching the ball. Who says the best plays are offensive highlights? How about that block? And then from deep range, Frampton? Are you kidding me? Like I said, the Hilltoppers are running downhill and away with this game.
Yes, 33-21, Western Kentucky over UTSA. Under 3 minutes to go until halftime. Some young fans in the stands inside the Star. And for Rick Stansberry and company, looking to advance to the semifinals. They are the regular season champions of Conference USA. They've lost in the finals of the Conference USA tournament for the last two tournaments, and that, of course, does not count last season when the tournament was called off. But UTSA, the hottest team in Conference USA going into this matchup, winners of 10 of their last 12 in Western Kentucky, not too many signs of rust, wouldn't you say?
No, their defense is excellent. Both these teams want to run, and right now, Western Kentucky is running better than Texas San Antonio. And the reason for that is Western Kentucky's defense. They're getting back, they're stopping the ball, then they're defending in the half court. Right now, they're just out-defending Texas San Antonio. And then, of course, with the stops and the blocks and the steals, now they're off and running some more. I think Western Kentucky is an okay half-court offensive team, but when they're locked in defensively and getting out on the break, then they can be elite.
Foul at midcourt with Eric Zumbel running the show for UTSA. Foul goes on Davion McKnight.
His fourth
team foul on Western Kentucky. Cedric Alley Jr. off glass.
Strong play by Alley. Came close to pushing off, but he liked that matchup against Frampton down low, just like they like Frampton outside. Just got to use your mismatches to each player's strengths.
Hollingsworth covered up. Bassey nearly won the ball. Keaton Wallace dribbles out of harm's way. Pull up and an air ball.
See if they go high-low here, try to get it into Bassey. No, isolation play for McKnight.
You say he does not play like a freshman. He kicks it out to Frampton, who's got a hoist with two on the shot clock and a bad miss.
You know, I'm surprised at that matchup because, I mean, Alley's 6'7", 230, and they tried to post up McKnight against him. I know McKnight is good, but I thought that matchup was in favor of Texas San Antonio, and turned out that he couldn't post up the bigger Alley.
So who'd have thought the two marquee players in this game, Javon Jackson for UTSA, Charles Bassey for Western Kentucky, have a combined 5 points with 19 minutes gone by in this game?
Now, the defense on Jackson has been terrific, but Bassey's impacting the game enormously defensively.
We go to a timeout. 34-23 Western Kentucky. Four quarterfinal matchups on the men's side, spread out across two courts inside the Star in Frisco. And there's another one in progress right now, Rice versus UAB. And we'll take a listen.
Mid-Atlantic, Florida.
looking to become the first Rice player to average 11 points, 8.5 rebounds, and 3.5 assists per game. And he's improved his game quite a bit this year, become much more well-rounded. This Rice team lost Drew Peterson, grad transfer to USC, and Fiedler is following right in his footsteps as far as production goes in the rebounding and assist category. Ron Jackson had that affected by Fiedler. Offensive rebound by Gordon, but he couldn't finish on the putback. Mullins trying to take him all the way. Dishes to Fiedler. Got blocked, but they call the foul.
That sequence was great there, Rice. Great defensive stop, able to push it in transition, but just a fast-running UAB defense to get back. But the foul. Let me come back.
Josh Appel, Danny Kluppinger on the call on the other channel, if you will, on watchstadium.com. That's a really good defense for Andy Kennedy and UAB. Final minute of the first half, Western Kentucky, UTSA, as Bassey muscles his way inside for a deuce.
It's called scoring before you get the ball. If Bassey can get the ball with a foot in the paint, he's going to shoot a really high percentage. And, you know, that was a good, strong roll. After the timeout, they got him the ball down there. Perfect spot.
Look at the discrepancy in points in the paint. And UTSA's offense has gone cold in the later stages of the first half. Just 9 for 35 from the floor. That's going to go up a little bit, but really Doc Keaton Wallace about the only player who's had his O game going in the first half of the Roadrunners. Foul called on the other end with 1/10 of a second left until halftime, and that's a foul against Wallace.
And that is about as significant of a mental error as I've seen Wallace make. He's a smart player, but fouling a player with 1/10 of a second left, who is frankly shooting a desperation shot, that's a bad way to go into the locker room for Texas San Antonio.
They just wanted to make sure it was a foul on a two-point try instead of a three-point try. And it was on a two-point try. So Tavion Hollingsworth, an 85% free throw shooter with a chance to pad Western Kentucky's lead. His foot is right on the line, and it's the outer line, remember, for the men's game.
But the most disappointing thing for Roadrunner fans is there was no way he was making that shot.
Correct. That's correct. He did make his first free throw. Here's the second. 7 points for the senior from Lexington. And Western Kentucky with a 13-point lead going into the locker room at halftime. A game that was much closer than the score would indicate, but Western Kentucky stifles UTSA on the defensive end down the stretch in the first half. Some star power in this game and some high-flying action as well. That was Carson Williams getting things going. Western Kentucky a double-digit lead at halftime in Frisco. Ready to start half number two. Doc, we were talking about the performance for Western Kentucky defensively in particular. UTSA's got some offensive playmakers. Keaton Wallace had a great first half, but Western Kentucky and Charles Bassey outstanding defensively.
Well, the Western Kentucky defense was really the story of the half to me, because not only did it shut Texas San Antonio down, but how about that dunk? It got Western Kentucky running with dunks and plays on the other end like that.
So UTSA is going to need more than just Keaton Wallace to get back into this game. Just 28% from the floor in the first half.
And they weren't open shots. It's Western Kentucky's defense has dictated this game. And not only are they well-schooled and play hard, but they have defensive talent. Bassey's is obvious, but look at Anderson there on Wallace. 6'6", great lateral movement, can block shots.
Maybe changing directions will help spark UTSA. Not on that possession, however, as Javon Jackson, or his noticeable absence from any kind of scoring impact on this game, has really been a major story.
And they've rotated defenders on him. Usually you're lucky if you have one player who could guard a Javon Jackson, and most people don't. But I've seen McKnight, Anderson, Hollingsworth all take turns on Jackson, and I just think they have excellent defensive personnel on this Western Kentucky team.
Maybe the change in who matches up against Jackson is keeping him out of rhythm. He's got to get used to a new defender every time as Charles Bassey plays the glass with the left hand.
That's a set play that gets Bassey the ball right in front of the rim. Well designed. You get a 6'11 athlete like that, the ball 2 feet from the basket, he's going to score.
Bassey with the rebound off the UTSA miss, and so far no signs of the Roadrunners offense turning to life after the break. Bassey, 4-3.
Get out of here. That's an NBA skill set,
yeah.
Obviously.
He's a 31% three-point shooter. Pretty good given his size. Wallace, lefty trigger. High rebound pulled down by Davion McKnight. Hollingsworth feeds Carson Williams, who was caught off guard by that pass, but was able to rally and score.
Remember we said both these teams want to run? Well, you can't run unless you get stops and rebounds and run off that. So the defense is feeding the offense for sure for Western Kentucky. All starts with the defense. And look at him chasing Jackson all over the place.
Lead is ballooned to 20 now for Western Kentucky.
And this is an interesting thing. When you can guard your own man in multiple, they don't have to help out very much on this team. Like right here, McKnight can chase Jackson all over because, you know what, he doesn't have to help out Anderson. Doesn't have to help out Bassey. Just keep Bassey around the lane. That's all the help you need. But they got a lot of guys who can win one-on-one defensive battles.
Cedric Alley Jr. with a closeout from Carson Williams. It did not matter. A much-needed three-pointer for UTSA.
Stole the words out of my mouth. That's exactly what I was thinking. Stop the bleeding for Texas San Antonio.
It's interesting. UTSA not terrible from three-point range tonight as Bassey misses from deep. They're 5 of 16, that's 31%, but it's the inside looks that just have not gone UTSA's way. Showtime, Josh Anderson. That's what he can do.
Defense to offense, it's a cliche, but it's true. That's a steal and score. The basketball pick six version.
Javon Jackson. Couple of taps on the rim. Jordan Germany is fouled after winning the offensive rebound.
There's the tap out from behind. The steal by Anderson. And then, of course, it's fun time going down there all by yourself. Can windmill it, do whatever you want. Anderson is a spectacular athlete, but so much more than a dunker. A lockdown defender. Look at Bassey diving on the floor. I love it.
Tavion Hollingsworth waits for his big man to catch up. Dude's breathing a little heavy right now. You can see why, the effort exerted.
So the NBA people watching Bassey are going to love that dive on the floor as much as anything. If they're going to pay someone that kind of money, they want someone who cares. And when you're diving on the floor, that's what coaches, everyone in your organization wants. A guy willing to give up his body.
Bassey with a right-handed jump hook.
Threes, posting up, diving on the floor, blocking shots, helping. Watch him help on the pick and roll here. Help. Now watch him get back to his man.
Jordan Germany.
Too much help. The first time the defensive breakdown on the pick and roll happened, I start praising the defensive pick and roll. I guess that's the announcer's curse. First easy basket we've seen Texas San Antonio get.
Truly, especially inside. Here's Carson Williams, who's just a great second option, really a bruiser inside for what Western Kentucky can do on the interior.
Throwing it deep into Bassey, that's automatic. Can't let him get it that deep. And then the steal, the dunk, the Hilltoppers are running.
Coming up, with Western Kentucky on top of UTSA 49-30 after this wraps up, 10 o'clock Eastern in the Conference USA Men's Tournament, Old Dominion and North Texas It's all on Stadium, the only free 24/7 network available on both television and digital devices without a cable subscription. Stadium, welcome to the game. All right, Doc, your chance to talk a little defense.
So McKnight guarding Jackson here, and he has one responsibility. Follow Knight. Look at him. He has no concerns about helping or rotating. Your job is to literally chase, not even go through screens, just chase him around. There's McKnight's talent winning a one-on-one battle. He has no responsibilities other than the coaches are saying, shut down Jackson. Don't worry about anything else. And, of course, he could do that when you got Bassey back there in the lane. Because if anyone does get beat, you don't have to help because Bassey will help.
Javon Jackson, this is a guy who averages over 20 points per game this year. He's one of the top 70 scorers in college basketball history. And he's got 3 points and is a meager 1 of 6 from the floor.
So this is a deep league. I thought there were 7 teams with the potential to win this conference tournament championship, but watching Western Kentucky's defense live here against a very good offensive team has me thinking the Hilltoppers might be a heavy favorite. If they can sustain this kind of defensive effort, boy, they could even survive a bad shooting night because their defense will give them a chance.
So in the second half, UTSA has already turned the ball over 3 times. Western Kentucky, the complete opposite of that. They're sharing the ball like it's going out of style. And a foul committed at half court. It looks like it's on Josh Anderson of Western Kentucky.
Well, Western Kentucky's scoring in transition off steals, off rebounds. But in the half court, Coach Stansbury is doing a terrific job getting the ball to Bassey down deep in the paint where he's going to finish. And so deep that there's not a double team opportunity for him.
Eric Zumbel stumbling his way into the lane, and that was taken right off the rack by Bassey.
And now they can run. Early offense.
Hollingsworth, as easy as it gets.
So you get the stop, fast break. The quick one isn't there, but then early offense, pick and roll. And within the first 10 seconds, you got a bucket. But it all starts with the stop and the ability to run and play fast and up tempo.
Jackson tried to hand off to Parrish. UTSA lucky to hang on. Germany's too strong. And Bassey starting to take over this game. 4 points in the first half. 9 already through the first 5 minutes of the second. And Bassey already has 8 rebounds for the game.
This is another play for Bassey coming up over here. He'll screen down and post. Not there.
So Davion McKnight takes the shot and misses it badly. Keaton Wallace gets it back from Germany. And Germany with a nice little finger roll.
Starting to work right now for Texas San Antonio. They've gotten a couple of those. But still a 21-point margin.
It's just every time you look at the score, it seems like Western Kentucky is lengthening its lead. Josh Anderson, more than just a dunker, you say, Doc, and you're right, but he's off the mark. There, his defense works in the takeaway, and he's basically tackled there by Eric Parrish. Can't do that even in the Star.
He got the wing knocked out of him. That was a hard collision right in the chest. But another athletic steal to save a layup. That was going to be a breakaway. But Anderson misses the shot, then athletic. Look, so he misses the shot. Well, that's afterwards. And that's boy, that's right in the sternum. That doesn't feel good. Mm.
Yeah, shoulder to chest.
Yeah. That takes the wind out of you right there.
Anderson clears his senses. Kenny Cooper, the redshirt senior, number 21 on the floor right now for Western Kentucky. Move, 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 move. Rawls, after a hesitation, less than 10 to shoot. Rawls puts it up. Looked like he might have been trying to team up with Carson Williams on an alley-oop. Neither option worked. And Keaton Wallace leads the charge the other way. He is dispossessed, but a foul against Western Kentucky. Number two on Frampton.
We're all five starters out of the game right now for Western Kentucky. A lot of confidence in their depth to go with a complete second team against Texas San Antonio.
Rawls, tough shot, and he cans it over Carson Williams.
Everything tough for Texas San Antonio. Wallace has made some of those, but Jackson has uncharacteristically not.
Well, what do you say about tough shots?
They're like me eating an Italian hoagie. They look great when they go down, but you can't keep doing it.
The second or third one,
yeah,
it's not working out for you.
Well, you just can't do it, literally. You can't eat Italian hoagies nonstop, and you can't keep making tough shots.
Well, Javon Jackson get it going with Western Kentucky's second unit on the floor. An air ball. I mean, these are just bad misses for Javon Jackson.
And Jackson was practicing those flick of the wrist, tough shots. I only got a half a second to get this off, and, you know, hasn't been able to come close to them tonight in game time.
He has scored in double figures in all but two of UTSA's games this season, and he commits a foul there. Lead continues to grow for Western Kentucky, 53-35 now. Hollingsworth and Bassey. A dump off and a dunk for the Hilltoppers. In command in Frisco. UNT Athletics. 53-35, Western Kentucky by 18 over UTSA. It's been a great second half, especially for that man, Charles Bassey. And look, for all the college basketball junkies in the audience, you've probably heard of Bassey before. He's not exactly new to anyone's radar. A big-time prospect coming out of Aspire Academy in Kentucky, number 6 overall in the country. Got off to a great start as a freshman. He was the Conference USA Rookie and Defensive Player of the Year. Helped lead the Hilltoppers to a big win over Wisconsin that season. Last year, 10 games in, he breaks his leg and maybe was as unknown as he's been in his basketball career since his later high school days, but he has roared back to national prominence in a big way this year. Conference USA and Defensive Player of the Year, and he's looking like a lottery pick, Doc.
Well, rehab is hard, and just getting better, even if you're healthy, is hard. So the fact that he put the work in and that he's come back with a higher motor and he's come back with a better shot and he's come back with better conditioning and more explosive and added some strength, what that tells the NBA is this is a guy who's willing to work. And, you know, what do they say, that hard work beats talent when talent doesn't work hard? So, you know, the world's filled with talented people who don't work hard. Bassey has unequivocally shown that he's not one of those. This is a guy who's going to put the work in. 2-3 zone right now, change up for the Hilltoppers.
A couple of free throws by Kevin Osawe gives Western Kentucky a 20-point lead. And Javon Jackson short from deep that time, but it stays with UTSA.
Back in the game, Cedric.
Jackson now 1-for-8 from the floor tonight. 3 rebounds and 3 assists, but just 3 points.
That's why you play the game. I didn't see that coming at all. That was actually a decent look. That was the first open look he had. He's probably a little surprised he was so open.
Wallace with a tough floater and give the senior 17.
The 2,000-point score. I mean, now he's making some tough shots here today. Again, I can't remember. There's the two pick-and-roll dunks. Other than that, I can't think of open, easy shots that Texas San Antonio's been getting.
Luke Frampton a little bit wide from the corner. And Jackson looks for space inside but brings it out. Holly working his way into the lane. Short. Rebound poked out by Jackson. Zumble inside. And a difficult lay-in.
Eric Zumble.
First points of the game for the native of Fair Verona, Italy. But our story tonight is in Frisco. By the way, Isaiah Cozart on the floor. He runs the pick and roll there for Western Kentucky, number 50. And the rebound snapped in by Keaton Wallace. Javon Jackson, finally. I don't know if you call that an easy bucket, Doc, but it at least goes for Jackson, just his second bucket of the game.
Not that easy. He showed the quickness and had to get it over a shot blocker and blow by some people. It was a very good play, but that's a normal play for Jackson.
Yes. Rawls does not convert. Wallace, one-on-one. Phoenix Ford with the rebound for UTSA. And Zumble topside.
Love the shot by Zumble, but I love even more the offensive rebound by Ford that gives the opportunity for that shot.
So Rick Stansberry calls a timeout. Suddenly it's an 11-point game. If you're just joining us, that's certainly not a narrow margin, but it's as close as it's been in a while after a 9-0 run for UTSA. The Roadrunners trying to run back into this game. Javon Jackson with a transition layup. They have not come easy tonight. And then a three-pointer from the top of the key forces the Western Kentucky TO. Steve Henson's offense has finally showed signs of life in the second half, but still an 11-point lead for Western Kentucky. Hey, it's tournament time, so be sure to join us on Sunday at 7 Eastern, coming up this Sunday for our Campus Hoops Insiders Selection Show. We all know you need help filling out those brackets. I certainly do, and we've got the place for you right here. Sunday, 7 Eastern on Stadium. Welcome to the game. So how about that offense for UTSA finally making an impact here on a 9-0 run?
Well, they got themselves back in the game, and the offense is certainly more effective here, transition, but I suspect it's because Bassey's not in the game, Anderson's not in the game, Hollingsworth wasn't in the game, McKnight wasn't in the game. Coach Stansberry completely emptied his bench, put in five subs, zero starters, and that's what started the run.
So this graphic was essentially reversed for much of the first half. It was UTSA missing the six consecutive shots, and it was Western Kentucky going on the 9-0 run. But still a lot of work to do for UTSA with 9:21 left, down 11.
Well, that is a manageable score. But again, I just think it's great to have confidence in your depth and to give people an opportunity. But sometimes you give them an opportunity and then they don't play as well as the starters. I mean, this starting group was rolling. And, you know, it was a 20-point game. They were up 20. So Coach showed some confidence in his bench and it didn't work out. We'll see if the starters now can get their momentum back. The starting lineup's back in. They went from a total second five to a total first five. But sometimes when you sit on the bench, you lose a little bit of momentum. Now, the other team gets some confidence because they've had the ball go through the basket.
Well, and it's an awfully hard call to make in these tournaments because Western Kentucky could end up playing three games in 3 days.
Yeah, I totally agree, but kind of mix it. Take a starter out here or there, but to go 5 for 5, and take out two all-league defensive players and a veteran defender like Hollingsworth and McKnight is going to be an all-defensive team guy. I mean, they have terrific defensive talent out there, and to go from that to the guys who aren't as good as that, well, now you go up 20 and all of a sudden you're up 11.
Keaton Wallace, following the foul by Josh Anderson, has 19 points now.
And that's the thing. You give your opponent some confidence in that situation, too.
Wallace's season high is 22. He's absolutely in the neighborhood of that right now with under 9 to play. The feed, it goes to Bassey. He's quickly double-teamed. And Rodriguez with the reach-in and the clean steal.
He doesn't play much, but good things happen when he's in. Look at that screen he set.
Concrete screen, but Wallace cannot convert.
He has stolen two passes today when West Kentucky tried to get the ball in the basket.
Redshirt junior from Tulsa, Oklahoma, doing the gritty things for Steve Henson tonight. Tough matchup, drawing the Conference USA Player of the Year.
And look at him leaning on Bassey. Look at that.
Only so much you can do, however, facing a guy of Bassey's caliber. Yeah, he can flex now, that's for sure.
Yeah, he kind of woke up the sleeping giant on that play.
He poked the bear.
Yeah.
Bassey said, enough's enough. I'm taking it to the rack whether you like it or not. He's got a free throw coming back with his Hilltoppers up a dozen. Fierce game in a way, in particular when you've got players of Charles Bassey's caliber. I've liked the song selections on our broadcast today, Doc. I don't know about you.
We got a good DJ back there.
Yeah, DJ Beavers, our audio tech, has been dropping some hits. 8 minutes to go in this quarterfinal round between Western Kentucky and UTSA. Winner moves on to the semifinal. Western Kentucky, the regular season champs. And the favorite, you would say, going into this matchup. But UTSA has won 10 of 12 coming in. And after a bit of a surge, UTSA was down by as many as 20 points earlier in the half. They're down by 12 now as Western Kentucky has made just one of its last seven shots. But Charles Bassey with the chance to complete a three-point play. And he does.
He really does have good form and good touch on his shot. He'll become a consistent shooter with his work ethic at the next level.
Does he remind you of maybe a James Wiseman at all, just thinking of another recent big as Wallace drops it in the bucket?
Yeah, I didn't study Wiseman enough to really weigh in on that. I actually imagine, though, Bassey being a little more physical and maybe more successful in the things that require physicality, which in the NBA is a lot.
Yes. That's not the first time he's hit a shot like that, and a bit of a shrug as he backpedals down the floor.
He gave the little Jordan shrug. How about that?
We've seen a flex. We've seen a shrug. Bassey has come alive in the second half. 15 points of his 19 since halftime. Take a look at this.
That's perfect form. And there's the little Jordan shrug. What's he thinking when he does that shrug?
Don't at me. That's what he's thinking. I'm that guy.
Yeah, he's a bad dude out here today, and he's been all year.
So, after Rick Stansbury brings his first unit back in, they've reestablished. Go figure, right?
Put your pro back in and all your all-conference defensive players and your 1,800-point scorers and your all-rookie team point guard, and all of a sudden you get the lead back.
Making the coach look like a genius, you know?
But at the same time, you know, clearly a great coach that we talked about earlier. And, you know, I come to think of it, even the top sub, Rawls, I don't even think was in there. So he had numbers 7 through 12 in at that time. And Texas San Antonio's good. I just think that it's a little bit too much of a substitution in terms of going from your top 5 to 7 through 12, top 6 to 7 through 12.
The concourse inside EA Diddle Arena, where Western Kentucky plays its home games, is actually named after Rick Stansbury's great uncle. So he's got long-standing ties to the program in Bowling Green before his head coaching tenure began. And Western Kentucky up at the top of the bracket, looking to advance to the semifinals. A quick turnaround, Doc, as they could potentially play at 5:30 local time this evening and then 11 a.m. Central Time tomorrow.
That's, you know, that might be why, now that you bring that up, maybe Coach Stansbury's way ahead of us. That might be why he was trying to get guys some extra rest.
Germany misses the jump hook. It's out of bounds. Steve Henson certainly thought it belonged to UTSA, but it's Western Kentucky ball. UAB leading Rice in the other quarterfinal matchup in progress across the arena from us, or on the other side of the curtain on court B. Winner of this game plays the winner of UAB Rice. Both games on watchstadium.com. Josh Anderson stripped and fouled as he elevated.
So that brings up an amazing point. So I'll quote the two impressive but less impressive numbers first. This year, Western Kentucky has made 55 more free throws than their opponents have even attempted. Last year, number one in the country, 136. Over the last 5 years, they've taken 1,155 more free throws than your opponent. If you paid the officials off, if you still wouldn't get an extra to get an extra 1,000 free throws, that just tells you the style of play: driving, posting, running, not settling, and the recruiting, getting athletic, high-end guys that can attack the rim.
Speaking of attacking the rim, Jordan Ivy Curry, who goes by Juice, has got 5 points now.
I have to backtrack. 1,000 more free throws than your opponents? Oh, my goodness. What I wouldn't have done for that as a coach. But maybe we didn't attack well enough and have enough athletic guys like Coach Stansbury. That blows my mind that you could shoot 1,000 more free throws over time than your opponents.
Clearly a point of emphasis for Rick Stansbury coached teams. It's, as you mentioned, something that extraordinary doesn't happen by accident.
It's an attacking style, running, driving, posting, with guys who are strong and athletic.
Javon Jackson whistled for another foul for UTSA, and it puts Davion McKnight at the foul line, where he converts on the 1-1. Javon Jackson tonight, Doc. 4 fouls, 5 points.
I'm frankly stunned. And like I said, I credit flat out West Kentucky's defense, because he didn't have easy shots. It's not like the shots he made, he should have made. They made everything tough. 2-3 zone.
Keaton Wallace with the left hand, and it's a season-high 23 Wallace. Now for Keaton Wallace.
And Wallace has just kept Texas San Antonio within at least a respectable range in terms of this margin of score.
Says hello to us. Still playing hard. What a career. Again, along with his battery mate, if you will, Javon Jackson, the third highest scoring duo in the same scoring class in NCAA history, the highest scoring duo from the same scoring class, recruiting class, that is, Johnny Dawkins and Mark Allaire at Duke. McKnight high off the glass.
I have to think, as a 2,000-point scorer, that someday his number will be in the rafters at Texas San Antonio, both Wallace and Jackson.
2-22 for the Roadrunners. Remember, they could come back next year, too. Cedric Alley Jr., I'll say he called bank.
So the NCAA is not charging anyone playing this year with the year of eligibility. Because of the constant testing and cancellations and playing in front of no fans, it's not a great student-athlete experience, at least compared to normal. But who knows how many kids will choose to come back. I think the more accomplished players will not. They'll want to move on to something different, especially the ones that have their degrees. But you never know.
They are a dynamic duo, the nation's highest scoring backcourt. They've combined for right around 4,700 points. And both of their numbers, their averages for this season are down from their career averages. Javon Jackson averaged more like 26, 27 points per game a season ago. And 2 years ago, when Keaton Wallace, who you see right there, was a sophomore, he was a legitimate 20-point per game scorer.
Yeah, what happens sometimes as a coach recruits more good players, yeah, you don't have to do as much. So yeah, it's really as simple as that sometimes.
Well, to just pigeon, or I should say, go back to your point about the types of players that might move on versus the ones that perhaps return. You've got Charles Bassey at the free throw line right now. Who knows what Jackson or Wallace will decide, but Bassey's a guy that you got to think is gone after this year.
Well, his situation is most people will need their degrees at some point, and Bassey certainly would do well to finish his degree, but Bassey is looking at NBA money, and that's, you know, you want to get that when you're in your prime. You, for someone of his talent, another great shot by Wallace, but for someone of his talent, you could always go back to school. You can't always command tens of millions of dollars.
Eighth 20-point game of the season for Keaton Wallace, but UTSA down 13 as we check in with UAB and Rice going on court B in the Star.
Abso doing a lot of work. Oh, what a pass over to Fiedler. And he absorbed the contact, and he'll shoot two. What a behind-the-head pass from Havsa.
It was a little bit of a fancy pass there, wasn't it? It goes back to practice and getting to know your guys and chemistry about where they're at. But great fancy find. And the big man able to draw the foul and get to the line. And now look at it, 43-48. Now it's a four-point game.
Yeah, just a moment ago, UAB had the lead at 9. Looked like they were going to pull away. But here's Rice. Chance to make it a three-point game, one possession, with 12 and a half to go, just about in this second half quarterfinal. Makes both. Fiedler
got away with a little bit of a arm bar there on the inbounds pass. Luckily didn't get called for it. Jalen Benjamin.
Whistle away from the ball.
No surprise to see a low-scoring game across the way with that really good UAB defense. A little bit more offense on our end, but Western Kentucky's defense has really impressed, especially holding one of the top scorers in the conference, Javon Jackson, to just 5 points. Charles Bassey has been brilliant in the second half. He misses from three there. Carson Williams.
That's a straight beast mode.
Yeah, really is. And Germany converts quickly on the other end.
So the best defensive teams in the league, UAB, North Texas, Western Kentucky, Louisiana Tech, this is the year in Conference USA that once again proves defense wins. You know, a lot of people now talk about, you know, analytics and offense and, you know, you need to score to win. I mean, these teams we're seeing defensively right now are the best in the league, and they're winning with defense.
Carson Williams pleading his case. He thought the chair was pulled out from underneath him there. Instead, it's ruled out of bounds on Western Kentucky. UTSA ball when we come back. Interesting development there. Charles Bassey heading off the floor. He's been great for Western Kentucky. 21 points and 9 rebounds as the Hilltoppers lead by double figures with 3:45 to go. His teammate in the front court, Carson Williams, has really had a great game as well. 15 points and 8 rebounds. Look at the hustle on the offensive glass and the putback. But that is not his best play of the game. This is our play of the game, as a matter of fact. Watch out. My dude skies and drops the hammer when he sees an open lane. Carson Williams really showing the well-roundedness, Doc, of this Western Kentucky team.
I mean, that dunk was crazy. But the rebound has to do with Ford boxed him out. He refused to be boxed out. Some players, you box them out, they stop. They say, okay, I'm boxed out. Williams kept fighting the box out and ended up with a big-time rebound.
That's the first shot UTSA has missed in its last 6 tries. Keaton Wallace has been great tonight, 26 points, but he's the only scorer in double figures for UTSA.
West Kentucky slowing it down, thinking time and score a little bit right now.
Josh Anderson back out to Jordan Rawls. And the rebound to Jordan Germany. Keaton Wallace nearly coughs it up. And Zumbel fouled on the three-point try. So there's Charles Bassey, coach. He's back on the floor and now on the bench, looking a little uncomfortable. And at this point, I'd be shocked to see him on the floor the rest of this game.
This is very concerning. He missed a game earlier with back issues. You see his body language right there. He knows that there's something not right. I actually had him and the Hilltoppers in a weekend series at Charlotte, and I saw him go through this there. You just hope that the trainers can do a great job and make him feel better. But that is a significant Conference USA development right there, because without Bassey at full strength, that is a factor that shifts the balance of power.
No question, because in a vacuum, that's a big deal. But given the fact that, provided Western Kentucky goes on to seal the deal here, they're playing at 11 a.m. local time tomorrow.
Yeah, that it's just concerning.
Yeah.
And you know what? Last time he was hurt, he was out for a game, came back, and we interviewed him after the game. That, you know, it looked like he played not 100%. And he says, listen, I wasn't going to miss it. I definitely knew I was going to play. And you know he feels that way in a conference tournament situation.
Tavion Hollingsworth with a defender blanketed on him still converts. 10 points for the father of two. And McKnight off the Jackson miss. Rawls is bumped by Zumbel.
Love the hesitation move.
So we mentioned that Charles Bassey was off the floor. He has since rejoined Western Kentucky's bench. Here's the play in question. A little slow there and a grimace on his face. And then that last moment of contact there almost seems like, no pun intended, it was the straw that broke the camel's back.
Boy, you just hate to see that.
Yeah, yeah. And it could be just nothing, you know, but, and he could be back in full form tomorrow, but.
Yeah, you really can't speculate on health, and you just hope for the best.
Wallace is swallowed up, and a foul is called on Western Kentucky's Josh Anderson.
Foul charge, Josh Anderson, his third.
So Coach Stanberry's not pleased with that, and it's not the officiating. He's, I think, addressing his own players, certainly with a lead late. You don't want to foul and give up points with the clock stopped.
Back in action.
That's not the time for aggressive mistakes. Sometimes people use, you know, I had one old coach that say, whenever someone says it was an aggressive mistake, he said, you know, back in the day, we would say it was a not smart mistake, because time and score enters into when you should be aggressive and when you shouldn't.
Well, as a coach right now with a lead like this, Hollingsworth tied up by Germany underneath, and the ball is out of bounds, and it is coming back to UTSA. You're largely oblivious about how much time is left, right? I mean, it's not like, okay, less than 2 minutes, I'm going to let my guys take their foot off the gas, play sloppy basketball.
No, everything's strategic. What you want to do right now, I said, you don't want to foul. You got to not extend as much, be more solid, not try to block shots, not go for steals. Like, you be solid. You make them score against a set defense. Make them earn a point with the clock running.
Carson Williams, two to shoot. Rebounded Germany. Jordan Ivy Curry handles the low pass. Finds the trailing Wallace. Allie with the offensive rebound.
So, you know, this is a good job here of not fouling. They get the basket, but the clock keeps going.
And who knows if this is Keaton Wallace's swan song with UTSA, but he's put on a show tonight, a game-high 30 points, shooting 50% from the floor. But with under a minute to go and Western Kentucky still up by more than 10, it looks like the Hilltoppers are going to the semifinal.
So we mentioned that Wallace and Jackson's hallmark is their consistency. From the day they stepped on campus, they've been standouts. And I just admire everything they've done, and I admire them leaving it all out there on the court in the last seconds of their senior years.
Davion McKnight coming to the end of his freshman year. And Rick Stansbury going to his bench in between free throws here. And an ovation for the top line for Western Kentucky from the Hilltopper faithful inside the Star.
Damian McKnight.
I like the idea of playing zone late when you have the lead, just because it makes your opponent take a little bit more time, an extra pass or two. Sometimes against man, they just drive right to the basket. You don't want to foul. And see right here, they have to make one, two, three, four passes. Just use a little more time against the zone.
Long rebound tracked down by Jordan Ivy Curry, and Juice swirls one down.
Jordan Ivy Curry with three.
Shot clock turned off. UTSA elects to foul Hollingsworth. We'll take this pause as an opportunity to show you our player of the game. Doc, no surprise, Charles Bassey. You
know, he was dominant as a shot blocker, you know, just not allowing any layups while he's in the game, and then just showed such soft shooting touch as a 6'11 center. I mean, he really couldn't have done anything more today. He scored inside, scored outside, was a dominant defender, and you just hope whatever back issues that he's having, you know, gets resolved as soon as possible.
Could very well become the first Western Kentucky Hilltopper to be drafted in the NBA in more than a decade. Jeremy Evans was the last player out of WKU drafted into the NBA back in 2010. Thank you to Andrew Feierstein in our stats and information department for digging that one up. And Keaton Wallace with a curtain call. Great outing for the senior and the Dallas native, 30 points.
So shout out to some of my guys, Brad Cohen, Hank Davis, OJ Lewis, who I was undefeated with because they were my wonderful walk-ons that always came in these situations. Whenever they played, we won. Cause and effect, I don't know. But all I know is I love those guys, played without a scholarship, and played without getting a lot of attention or playing time, but just worked hard every day to make the team better.
Cozart with the rebound for Western Kentucky. Jackson Harlan on the floor for Western Kentucky. Bailey Conrad as well. Helping Western Kentucky put the finishing touches on a 13-point win in the quarterfinal of the Conference USA tournament. So Western Kentucky, I think, definitely looking the part of the number one seed.
No, terrific performance. They subbed a little bit, and Texas San Antonio made a run at that time. Other than that, Western Kentucky in control the whole way with outstanding defense.
80-67, the final score. Western Kentucky awaits the winner of UAB and Rice in the 11 a.m. Central Time semifinal tomorrow. And an all-around performance for Rick Stansbury's team, both offensively and defensively. And we've got Coach Stansbury on the other line now. Coach, thanks very much for joining us. Congratulations on making it through to the semifinal. Look, a lot of attention is paid to your offense, and rightly so. But in particular, what did you think of your team's defensive effort tonight, specifically holding a scorer like Javon Jackson to just 5 points?
Well, first off, you know, give San Antonio a lot of credit. They've got a terrific team, and Coach does a great job with them. But I thought the difference of the game was what you just said, especially the first half. You know, he's so capable of beating you himself, and we've seen that movie before. But I thought, you know, for the most part, Davey, our freshman guard, guarded him about as well as you can guard him. You know, Wallace is probably the guy that hurt us more than anybody. But, again, overall, I hadn't seen the stat sheet yet, but I know how the game went. Defensively, I thought we were pretty good.
Hey, Coach, I mean, the defense was terrific. Any other thoughts on this game?
Well, your concern's always finding a way to win that first one. I've always said the team that's played the first night has the advantage. San Antonio played last night, and we didn't. Never got an opportunity to practice in here. We never got an opportunity to shoot around in here. So that's a concern. But in some ways, hey, no better than we shoot it. That's not all bad. We try to throw it to the paint and drive it to the paint. I thought we did that pretty well.
Coach, a great performance for Charles Bassey tonight. 21 points, 9 rebounds. You've got an awfully quick turnaround before the semifinal tomorrow morning at 11 o'clock Central Time. Based on what you know now, do you think Charles is going to be good to go for that game?
Well, we'll see. I know he went out there with a, you know, hurt a little bit there. So we'll see where he's at. It's quick turnaround for everybody. So we just got to find a way to be ready. Hope he's ready to go.
A great game tonight, Coach. Thanks a lot for joining us.
Thank you.
Rick Stansbury once again. As Western Kentucky through to the semifinal, again, they await the winner of the 2-6 matchup, UAB versus Rice. And we're cruising through the Conference USA tournament. Awfully fun week here deep in the heart of Texas. We've got more quarterfinal action for you on Stadium before the night is through. But for right now, it is Western Kentucky on top of the hill. The Hilltoppers take care of business in their opening action of the CUSA tournament. A 13-point win over a really good UTSA team. They had won 10 of 12 coming in. No problem for Charles Bassey, the NBA prospect, and his fellow Hilltoppers. Much more from the Star later on tonight on Stadium.